Parents should be communicative and candid with children even after the age of maturity. Be empathetic with the children. Avoid ego when they interact with you. Treat children like friends, of course, keeping mutual respect intact. They grow up fast. There is nothing harm in discussing the dynamics of human anatomy and the mysteries of masculine and feminine features with your children. A mother can counsel a daughter, and so also can a father to his son. It is akin to a tightrope walking, but needs imagination. Further, I feel that the outstanding movie directors can produce short films on this subject creatively and imaginatively, and this will be a great service to the society. Demystifying sex. Sex is the greatest fantasy and the greatest magic in life. Unfortunately, it has become a fierce gambling game. It is predominantly used as the greatest entertainment in our society. It is a $1 trillion business world over. The merchants of sex in entertainment industry world over make the 2 minutes pleasure into a lifelong fantasy. Unfortunately, people do not realize its negative impacts on health and peace. Its after effects will be obviously manifested in old age. Remember, young age is not permanent. Seasons change, so also age. Wisdom demands that sex shall be used for procreation, not for daily entertainment. For every pleasure, there is pain in store. Spirituality suggests that one has to master the passion. Need for moral science lessons and gender-sensitive syllabus in schools. Today's children are intelligent, well exposed, and they update knowledge in various domains of life. They think ahead of times thanks to the pervasiveness of information technology. They must be taught imaginatively the dynamics and mysterious way of functioning of human body within the backdrop of science and spirituality. The boys must be taught to display mutual respect while interacting with women and children. Introduction of courses on spirituality and moral science is a compelling necessity than a choice. The society must strive for the dawn of a renaissance in gender relations based on dignity, gentleness, and justice. We have to go back to the basics as taught by our forefathers. State administration assisted by police alone cannot adequately deal with the problem. Society's active participation is a must. Many parents lament today it is uncertain whether their children will safely return from the school before the dusk. A predator attacking her at a desolate place would be deadlier than any worst danger she may face in her life. She is insecure, fearsome, and anxious. She feels as if she is walking through risky minefields. All accomplishments and achievements in politics, economics, GDP, technology, trade, business, commerce, and international relations will prove to be nothing if we consistently fail to rescue a hapless woman in cursed moments of horror. It has been empirically proved that economic growth of a state per se cannot deliver good quality life. The failure of every successive government to prioritize women's issues speaks poorly of handling their administration. Cicero, the Roman statesman and philosopher, said, "The safety of the people shall be the highest law." This is a country where a railway minister, a man of integrity, had resigned taking moral responsibility for the train accident in 1956 in which 142 people were killed. When the National Crime Records Bureau reveals that a rape takes place every 15 minutes in India, the authorities and the nation as a whole cannot treat it as just another data or news. Well, as a nation should not lose sensitivity to the human side of life. If so, it will lead us to all-round chaos, endangering happiness, peace, and health of all.